Hello everyone, this is Pastor Shaquila, and today I'm just sitting outside with my grandson as he run around. Yeah, you hear him? And having a good time and just enjoying the cool breeze out here. I just wanted to come on because if you remember the very first time I did a recording and I told you what this was going to be all about, my YouTube channel, I remember saying that it's, you know, the good, the bad, the ugly. Sometimes as pastors, a lot of people may look up to us and ministers, and I'm not saying showing respect, because we all show respect to each other, but to know that we also go through things and it's how we come out of it. And so I said I wanted to come on and share this experience that happened just this week. And I was reminded of a word that I put up on YouTube maybe 2 weeks ago on what's in your pocket. So it's very important that when you're going through, to know what you need to know what to do to come out of it. Well, a lot of you all may have come on Tuesday when I ministered. I invited you all to come and be a part of that. That was this Tuesday, this week. And so I prepared my word, and the word title was a question: Do I fear God? And I wanted everyone to get a chance to look at themselves and ask that question and to answer honestly. Well, as I was ministering it, I felt almost a struggle. And I said, okay, Lord God, I know that you gave me this word. Why is it such a struggle as I'm ministering it? And after I finished ministering it, I didn't feel like I did good at all. I was like, oh my God, I felt like really like I bombed out. And so I asked my husband, and my husband and my son was there. My son, he's behind the camera. He's usually the one that's recording. And he looked at me like, Mama, what you talking about? I said, I don't feel like I did good. How did I do? Be very honest. I know I'm your wife, I'm your mother, but be very honest. And it was like, you did an awesome job. My husband was like, Shaquila, I think we need to do that on a Sunday. That was an awesome word. It was so good, so good. And my son was saying the same thing. And so at first, you know, you kind of go in that place of, oh, they just trying to be nice. And I just kept asking them. And then my daughter came by and I asked my daughter, and she was like, Mom, no, that word was amazing. It was so detailed and in depth, and they was going on and telling me points that really stood out to them. And then I said, okay, see, you got to know yourself. And so when they said that, I said, okay, then I understand it's the enemy trying to come against me. Now, in the past, and some of you all may know it, I don't think many people may know it, that sometimes I get into a place of depression and the woe is me. You know, I'm just being honest. I told you, good, bad, ugly, I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to be honest. Yes, I'm Pastor Shaquila, but I'm not perfect. And so I was in that place, and I didn't deal with it too much that night. You know, I was tired. I went to sleep, got up the next morning, and now I'm feeling myself going into a place of depression. Like, oh God, what's wrong with me? I felt heavy. I felt like, you know, man, you know, my word wasn't good. So I'm still at that place and I'm going through. Didn't really want to talk to nobody. Oh my God. And then I had to wake up. And then the Lord reminded me, Pastor Shaquila, what's in your pocket? And I said, oh, okay. That's all I needed to hear. I know what I need to do. And so I begin to go through the house and I begin to declare what God says and who God says I am. And I put on some praise and worship music. And I was going to try to wait till my grandson go to sleep, because, you know, I keep him during the day. But I said, you know what? He is no stranger to praise and worship. And so I put some music on and I said, I'm going to praise myself out of this, because the devil's trying to get a hold on me and he going to let me go today. And so I begin to praise God, and I begin to pray, and I begin to declare, and I begin to speak what I want to see happen in my life, and I'm not going to be held down by the enemy. Now, you know, I always tell people, don't mess with my praise. I promise not to mess with yours, but please don't mess with my praise, because you don't know what God's done for me. After I finished praising God, oh my God, I felt so good. It's like it broke off of me. And I said, thank you, God. Because see, let me tell you, as pastors, we get up there and we speak a word, but we got to be able to walk in it ourselves, you know, which is so very important because this is a way of life. It's a journey for us all. So we encourage each other and not judge each other. Amen. So I just wanted to share that because I promise you the good, the bad, the ugly. And so I'm not saying that I'm going to always do things as I should, but I thank God that God is full of mercy and grace and that I can be able to get it right and correct and be able to share it. That's important. That's important. We're not all perfect, but we serve a perfect God who is doing a work in every one of us. So I just wanted to come on really quickly and share that with you. And thank you all once again for being a part of my YouTube channel and subscribing. Oh my God, God is amazing. I'm in such a better place. I am doing so good, so good. And I just thank God. God is faithful, y'all. He is so faithful and he is in control. Thank you so much again. And remember, spread love every day. What the world needs is more love. You see my grandson? Say hi. Hello. Say hello.
Draw.
Okay, he's saying draw. He wants to draw on the pavement. All right, let's get our chalk. God bless you.